Hello, law aspirants. So, education is that tool which can totally change this world. Change the world, something that you can mold, recap, something that you can totally amend, reform, make something new, make better, modify, something which will bring a total change in you. Yes, this is what is wanted in all of you. Let's begin with our roots. This change should be visible, as change is part and parcel of human life. Let's begin with our roots. I'd left one of the root incomplete, right? So let's begin with that same root where we left. Okay, let's begin with this word where we left yesterday. And I think I started with VOC, that is a call, something that is you can hear, something which can be called out. And the word vociferous, I told you, very important word, that is something very loud, shrill, yelling, shouting, roaring. Okay, and vocation, I asked you to read. Yes, did you? Toru Dutt's poem, the famous poem, My Vocation, My Profession. Every man has a task, and we all have to fulfill that, meet the task which God has given us on this earth. Let's begin with today's word. Very interesting word, a vocation. A vocation is a calling away from your job, hence a hobby or a pastime. In fact, if we could use the word, that is killing time. Or, you know, a kind of thing just done for a time pass. This is a hobby, it's leisure time. Your free time you want to spend as you want to. Have you heard of those lines from the poem? What is this life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. Wonderful poem. The name of the poem itself is Leisure. Read, dearies, read. This is reading, and reading is really going to help you out. Next word is advocate. To advocate is somebody who calls towards as a show or a support of something. So that is advocate. Invoke. Invocation. I would really take these words. These words are more often used in epics and poems which are long. We call upon God. Invocation is a prayer to God. In fact, God is called upon to help. You invoke God, yes, in during the examination, all of us, in all difficulties, all tight corners, we invoke God. God, come to our life, come in our life and just help us out. That is invocation, a prayer to God. God is being asked to be part and parcel of our life. The next word, revoke. So, re is again. And revoke is call back something. You are reviving something and bring back to life. Irrevocable means something which cannot be called back. You cannot make that thing happen again. So that is irrevocable. You can't call it back. Yes? Okay. Next word in the same scenario. Provoke. Very interesting word. Have you heard of this idiom? Add fuel to fire. Insight. Why? Because you call forth, you make things in such a way, you are provoking someone. And the same way, like provocation is calling forth, making things happen forcefully. Evoke. Evocation and vocalize is call forth. What is forth? That is forward. Evocation is the act of calling forth. Vocalize is to call with a voice. Remember the root walk? Yes. So, the same way you're calling and you are using a voice, at the top of your voice, you're calling something. The basic meaning of the root is there. See, I have told you and I repeat again. Every time, you don't have to do any rote learning. You don't have to mug up anything. So, just remember one thing, that I may forget these words, not a problem. We are human beings, not machines. And machines do not stand in front of human beings, nothing. So that is why, don't mug up. Just remember the words and keep reading them, adding on to your words, and remember the root meaning of it. Okay? Next word we take up, and the next root, very interesting root for today, that is fik. Fik is to make or do something. See, in the usage of the word fik, in so many words we have used it. Yeah, such an interesting thing. I really love it, and I hope you also relish it and love it the same. Purification is the process of making something pure, something which is making it pious, divine, holy, right? Distilled. Synonym for the word purification I've given. I would also give you one of the Greek words which have come by Aristotle. Do you know that word? You're interested to know? Yes, this is the word catharsis. Catharsis means purification or purgation. To vent out your feelings. It is a purgation when you take out whatever is hidden in your heart, and it is a purification because you don't load your heart with things. Please note the word very carefully. It's from Aristotle's books, Poetic, written long back. So it is a purgation, a purification. Whatever is a burden on your heart, you vent it out. See, V-E-N-T, I'll take up the root in future. Again, this means something is an outlet to take out. Pent, control, vent out. No? Pent up, control your desires, vent is a ventilator, that is an outlet. Certification is you're making sure, in fact, you are attesting something, you're making sure that the thing is right. Pacify or pacification from the root PAC, that is calm or quiet. So that means tranquil, serene, repose. Something in a calm and a quiet state. So pacification, we talk, or we are very pacifying attitude we are applying towards Pakistan's terrorism. We're not answering them back in the same manner, although they've been very aggressive and belligerent and pugnacious with us for a long time. Pacific is making a peace. From the same words, two can be linked together. Artificial is made with human skill, that means not real, not natural, although human efforts have been put in to give it a kind of a replica of nature. Magnificent is large, great, something beautiful, glorious. Magnificent performance, wonderful, beautiful. Par excellence, something which is exquisite, excellent. He is deficient in, that is lacking in something, you are not doing things in the proper way. See, there's a grammar usage here, I really want to pinpoint that out. It's an underpinning. The word, when we use, you are good at any field, any work. I'm good at English, good at vocabulary, and same way, you are deficient in or lacking in maybe grammar, vocabulary, any field again. But when there is deficiency of nutrients, vitamin A, vitamin B or anything, so that is vitamin, mineral, salts, this is off. See the preposition used, deficient in, deficiency of or good at. They can be linked together and be remembered. You should be good at vocabulary, at comprehension, can understand and grasp the meaning out of the things. Next word is the word which is sacrifice. Sacrifice is make something very sacrament, holy and pure. By the sacrifice, you know, make something good. By your sacrifice of all your social medias and things, you are going to really clear clad and come out in flying colors. Difficult, the root fic again, that is not made easily. It's something which is, you have to put in your best, even then you find it very difficult. Efficient is again the same word as I used, proficient or something that you can do thoroughly. I just changed my marker's color. Proficient, or you're apt at anything? Efficient, proficient, or efficient? Beneficial. What is the root ben? Yes, students, ben means very good, good. Born means the same, good. So anything that happens for good, beneficial, is something which will happen for good. We have three roots in English in the sense of good. And significant is very important, pivotal, which makes a mark, which makes an impact, which is indelibly written, something which cannot be erased. This was a significant or landmark achievement. Something happening in a very great form, magnificent form. Right? So, the notes of the roots have been done. Yes, that is, are taken up in connection with the root work, that is called fic, that is make or do. And we are turning to next root, that is magan. Be magnanimous, students, or be, you know, magnificent or magnifying something which is large. Yes, large or great. Now, when we take a simple word, from simple to complex, we move to various words. Magan is large or great. It's magnifying glasses, glasses which make a small object also greater in size. We have to think, see things with the magnifying glasses, that is large, right? Magnification is something great in size. You make something, you know, remarkable. Very important or pivotal. It's of paramount importance. Magnitude. Be your magnitude or your size or your stature or your position should be so great that everybody adores and loves you. It was a magnificent performance. Large. You can see this root. Magan, large. Fic is to do. So that's the same word which we did here, because it's both the roots which are common in this. Fic is do. Magan is large. So you do something in a large form, that is magnificent. Magnanimous. Please know this word. Very important in English. The root that works in this, anim, is mind or soul. So, when you're a very large-hearted person, you possess a great soul, you're ready to help people, that is the word magnanimous. So, my magnanimous students, magnify your glasses, read the vocabulary words, grasp the meaning out of them, understand them, not only understand them, keep doing your passages, keep applying them in these words, and you really feel will the difference. See, your lukewarm performance won't lead you anywhere. What is important is your boiling point, and which is 100 degrees centigrade, right? So, this is my advice to you, and I hope you would really follow it. Right, students? Thank you.